When I teach integration by parts, the most common question that I get from students is, how do you figure out what to make U and what to make DV? So in this video, we're going to talk about some of the tricks of the trade and some of the things you should think about when figuring out how to split your integrand into U and DV. The first thing is that there are some functions that get much, much, much simpler when you differentiate them. So if you take the derivative of the natural log of x, you get 1 over x dx. That's way simpler than natural log. If you take the derivative of the arctangent of x, you get 1 over 1 plus x squared dx. That's way simpler than arctangent. If you take the derivative of the arcsine of x, you get 1 over root 1 minus x squared dx. Way simpler than arcsine. So if you get one of these functions that really like to be differentiated, you should think about making those u and making the rest of the integrand dv. On the flip side, if you run into something that really doesn't want to be integrated, don't make that dv. So if you almost never want to put a 1 over x into dv, because when you then you'd get a log x in v. You never want to put 1 over 1 plus x squared in dv, because then you'd get an arctangent. You never want to put 1 over root 1 minus x squared in dv, because then you'd get an arcsine. Things that get way, way more complicated when you integrate them do not belong in dv. So whether you have a function that gets much simpler when differentiated or much worse when integrated, in either of those cases, you probably want to put it into u and not into dv. Now, there are some functions that get a little bit simpler when differentiated. The derivative of x to the n is n x to the n minus 1. Well, n minus 1 powers of x is simpler than n powers of x, and you can imagine doing it over and over again n times until you get a constant, and constants are really easy to handle. So polynomials are a good thing to try to differentiate unless they're in competition with one of those functions that really don't want to be differentiated. Sines and cosines in e to the x, they don't care. The derivative of sine of x is cosine of x. The derivative of cosine of x is minus sine of x. The derivative of e to the x is e to the x. Differentiate these functions, and they just turn into themselves. Integrate these functions, they just turn into themselves. So they're good neutral things that you can put wherever you want, and they just won't mess things up at all. And then there, every once in a while, you find a function that actually gets simpler when it gets integrated. So for example, if you had x e to the x squared, 2x e to the x squared, then you would say, oh, v is e to the x squared, and e to the x squared is simpler than 2x e to the x squared. Left out the dx. Okay. The integral of 1 over x squared is minus 1 over x. So if you have a 1 over x squared, maybe it wants to be part of dv. But the point is, there is a hierarchy. Some functions really want to be differentiated. Those belong in du. Some functions kind of want to be differentiated. Well, put them in du if there isn't better competition. If something else, like a log, wants to be in du, it's not so bad to put that into dv, because when you integrate it, it doesn't get that much worse. So, for example, suppose that you had integrated x squared arctangent of x. In this case, you'd say x squared wants to be differentiated, but only a little bit. Arctangent desperately wants to be differentiated, so we'll let arctangent be u. And then we'll let x squared dx be dv. And when you differentiate the arctangent, it gets much simpler. You integrate the x squared, it only gets a little bit more complicated. You win. On the other hand, if you have x squared sine of x, you say x squared kind of likes to be differentiated. You know, if you take its derivative, you get 2x, which is simpler. And sine x doesn't care. So you make this the thing that gets differentiated, and this the thing that gets integrated. It doesn't mind being integrated. This kind of wants to be differentiated. Make them both happy. Last trick is if you don't see how to split things up, you can always pick the entire integrand to be u and just let dv be dx. So here's the rule. When all else fails, let everything be u and let dv be dx. And then du will be f prime of x dx, and v will just be x. So the integral of anything dx is x times that anything. So this is u, this is dv, this is u, this is v, this is v, this is du. So if you ever find something that gets simpler when you differentiate it, try the trick of letting dv be dx. So for example, if you want to integrate natural log of x, you get x times the natural log of x minus the integral of x times the derivative of natural log. That's 1 over x. Well, that's just 1 dx, and that's an easy integral. If you want to integrate arctangent, you just get x times the arctangent minus the integral of x times the derivative of arctangent. And this is an integral that you can do with a u substitution. You just let u equals 1 plus x squared. Du is 2x dx, so it's 1 over u du divided by 2, and you get a natural log. Okay. Finally, if you can't do anything to make your integral simpler, try to make it similar. That was the going in circles trick. If you've got an integral that's of the form u dv, look for ways to integrate by parts. Maybe you'll have to integrate by parts twice to do this, to turn it into a bunch of stuff plus a multiple of the original integral. And then you just subtract off k times the integral from both sides, and you get 1 minus k times the original integral equals the stuff. And you get that the original integral is the stuff divided by 1 minus k. And of course, you always have the arbitrary constant. Okay. Warning, this often requires more than one step, and it's particularly useful for combinations of e to the x and trig functions, or two different trig functions, especially with different frequencies, or the same trig function. It works for all of those cases.